David Yakimischak. I'm the Executive Vice President and General Manager of SureScript. SureScript is the prescribing company in the United States that's owned by pharmacy and PBM.
I mean, I think it's very important to establish a strategy and a business plan around data and around the sharing of data within pharmacy. I think one of the most important things that a pharmacy can do is establish relationships in the community with the other care providers. So that would be the hospitals, the IDNs, the medical clinics, the convenient care clinics, any of the other sports medicine, any of the rehab services, home care, long-term care. There's so much healthcare that's going on out there, so much healthcare provision that those relationships are very critical, because I think the first thing that has to happen is the pharmacy needs to establish a business and a clinical relationship with these entities. Once that's in place, the technology will take care of itself. Community pharmacies should recognize that they have a lot of very valuable data. Clinical data, it could be administrative data, it could be point of sale data. And there's really a couple of different strategies that they could look at, but one is to say, if I hold on to the data and keep it to myself, I'll retain the customer. The other, though, is to say, if I share that and become part of the community and share that information with other care providers, they will bring me into the care circle and I'll be able to participate in the new healthcare models as they evolve. If they share the data, it'll be known to the community that they're open and sharing that information, and they may well get more referrals and more business from doing that. But then there are so many other healthcare providers that would benefit from that, like the primary care physician. Now, if they know that one of their patients is getting their immunizations at a pharmacy, they may be more likely to refer that patient for additional immunizations. So it's really a revenue opportunity in for a pharmacy. And in the world of clinical data, the most obvious first data source is going to be the dispensed history, the medications and prescriptions that have been filled by the pharmacy. That's one. But now more and more pharmacies are offering immunization services, as well as some diagnostic services. Could be medication therapy management or retail clinic encounters. So there's a richer and richer data set available, including the prescription information. And that information is very valuable to yourself, but also to the rest of the community. If I could give an example, medication adherence is a very important dimension of the new healthcare models. The patients who are most adherent to their medications are most likely going to be lower cost patients to the entire health system. So knowing whether a patient is adherent to their medications or not becomes very important to a pharmacist, but also very important to the physicians and all the care providers for that patient. If a patient's not adherent, there's people who need to know about that, and they need to help in the interventions to try to help get that patient back adherent with their medications. You want to look for partnerships that help get you to the audience that's important to you. Well, the first thing I would say is you don't have to solve it all by yourself. It is an approach that one could take is to say, well, I'm going to do this myself. I'm going to establish the connections, the relationships, build the software and the engines that are necessary. But really what you want to look for is a set of collaborative partners. And whether that's in the world of software in your dispensing system or in your pharmacy management system, it could be in the networks that you connect to and the partners that you have. You want to look for partnerships that help get you to the audience that's important to you and that provide the services and the products that help you meet your objectives.
Please visit us at drugtopics.com. Join us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter.